This time, I would like to talk about decrypting 1Password without writing a single line of code. Last time, we stopped at learning the basics of 1Password business. Let's take a closer look on what's happening behind the scene when we use 1Password. First, we can see the API call to auth start. Then a response would return a JSON format user auth to us. Then we can see there is this encrypted data we send to auth, and the response with encrypted data to us. Finally, we send this 8256 GCM encoded JSON body to auth verify, and they responded back with the same 8256 GCM encoded JSON body to us. We can see the application starts working from there. After that, we ask for key sets and personal account information and so on. To break the authentication down, we need to understand a few things first. Let's do a quick Google search to see if there is anyone who has published their work on 1Password before. Cause they say don't reinvent the wheel. This link doth know looks very promising. And this blog post actually helped me to get started. This is what it says. In 1Password encryption, there is an important protocol called two-secret key derivation, as known as 2KSD. Obviously, the name suggests that it would involve two keys. First one is secret key, which is generated dynamically in user's browser. The other one is master password, which is the user's password. By using them, browser can derive two keys for different situations. First one is MUK, or master and lock key. The other one is secure remote password key, SRPX. This sounds complicated, but trust me, it will get easier because a high-level abstract, it's gonna help us to understand how encryption and decryption works in 1Password. About the secret key in 2KSD, it looks something like this. After user create an account in 1Password, it will return a long string to you and user will need to save it in local environment. Otherwise, if the secret key is lost, there is no way for 1Password to recover account access for you. And we will get into the reason of that behavior later in the series. In order to derive master and lock key, or MUK, 1Password leverages browsers or local clients' computing power to compute the key. Reason for this is simple. If the secret key or the password is computed on server side, the point of data encryption is lost entirely. First, to compute the MUK, local client normalized user's email address and secret key. Then, it will perform a HKDF function on them. Then, it will continue to do some crypto iterations. And it will continue to derive the key. And finally, the local client is able to derive the value of MUK. None of this matter, considering most of the computation here could be handled by JavaScript or our local client. There is no point for us to really understand what is going on here. But it is always good to know what information we need in order to get the value of the MUK. They are email address, user-defined password, and the secret key. To fully understand how MUK works, naturally, we will want to go through the process ourselves. But it would require a lot of work and understanding of cryptography and coding. Fortunately, we don't have to do all of this from ground. We are already in a great position to compute the value without touching a single line of code, thanks to darthnode.org. I found a lot of useful scripts on their GitHub repo, and let us put all of these together and see how a simple script is able to help us to get the value of MUK. Here is the script I got from darthnode. First, I enter my email to the script, then my secret key, and then the algorithm, integrations, and sorts I got from 1Password. Don't worry about them too much now because they will be covered why I'm entering them in coming videos. After the script computes for around 1 second, finally it will show us the value of MUK in the bottom. It is a base64 encoded string. Now, on a high level, we understand how to get the value of a very important part of 1Password, MUK. But are we ready to decrypt password now? You might think that now we can use MUK to encrypt or decrypt 1Password request or response, but unfortunately, we're just touching the surface here. We still have a lot to go through. Fault key set, recovery key set, team key set, and master key. But don't worry, after understanding how first encryption decryption works, this will just be a rabbit hole repeating itself. It is not that hard after going through the first iteration. Okay, now we're equipped with the knowledge of the creation of MUK. Let's take a step back and see what's going on when we first create our account in 1Password. First, we provide our email and password to it. Then, it would return a secret key to the client. In the meantime, it would also compute a master key set for us, which is encrypted by MUK, which we covered in previous slide, to encrypt and decrypt all of our key sets. And what is the purpose of master key sets, you may ask? The purpose of it is we can use it to encrypt or decrypt key sets for 1Password, including fault key sets and recovery key sets. You may wonder what fault key sets do. First, fault is a place to store our passwords. So naturally, the purpose of the fault key sets are to encrypt and decrypt the fault items, aka passwords in 1Password. Now you should be able to see a pattern here that how we are using MUK to encrypt, decrypt the master key sets here, and then how we are using the master key sets to encrypt, decrypt the vault key sets, and then use the vault key sets to decrypt the password in 1Password. But this is not all of them. We still have recovery and team key sets to go over, but we can talk about them later in the series. For now, we focus on the basics first. Again, it is not easy to understand this without some actions. Let's go to an example and see how we can get the value of master key. The JSON body that we are seeing here is actually what our browser or client would see as well. After setting up or logging in 1Password, this information is saved in our local environment. So this is what our computer would see. The true identity of this JSON is actually that encrypted version of master key that we mentioned earlier. The reason that I know it is the master key is because the value of the KID is MP here. In 1Password, if the value of the KID field is MP, then it is the master key. Other fields like encryption, P2C, algorithm, P2S, they are all necessary in order for us to compute the value of MUK. Remember in the previous slides, with the value of MUK, we can theoretically decrypt the value of master key and get the plaintext value of MUK. By running the script from .null on the right, we can easily obtain the plaintext value of master key. Now let's go through this together. First, we enter the MUK we computed earlier, just like the previous slides. Then we enter the base 64 encoded IV from the left hand side, which is coming from the JSON body I've showed you earlier. And finally, we tell the script that what are we trying to decrypt, which of course is coming from the left hand side, the JSON body of our master key. And after pressing enter, that we can see a plain text master key in the graph. There is a very interesting field in the graph, in the JSON body of the decrypted version of master key. It is key ops. Key ops, obviously, it means that this key that we have decrypted here, the master key that we have decrypted here, it is capable of decrypting and encrypting here. So it means that we can use this key to either decrypt the encrypted version of Fort's key set, or we can use this key here to encrypt the Fort's key set. But in order for us to do this, we will need the K value here. This value, does it look familiar to you? It actually looks exactly like the MUK value that we used in this script. The reason for that is that they are so similar because they are actually reusing the same concept, the same crypto procedures for this to happen. So this is why I said earlier that after we go through the first iteration of encryption decryption, then we can easily understand how the rest work. To wrap up, now we know how 2KSD works on a high level. MUK or Master Unlock Key is computed using our email address and password. Password items are stored in Fort and encrypted by Fort key sets. And how we can somehow apply the same encryption decryption technique on the relationship between MUK, master key set, Fort key sets, and password. I think now we are ready to see how to hack 1Password by just reading it. It will be on the next video. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one. Thank you.